This is John Casey. He came on with 9:16 gone in the first period. Fuhr is out for the season with a knee injury. David's shot from the blue line. Kept in by McCown. 9 seconds. That's all that's left of the penalty. The Leafs trying to bang one in here, but it'll be McCavish who'll clear the zone. Got it as far as the line. Apparently it got out over, and that's offside at the St. Louis blue line. 11:35 remaining in the third period. Leafs were up 2 goals. The Blues came back to tie it up 3-3.
Be part of the play.
Corson, Huddy, and Barron, the marksman for St. Louis. We are nearing the 9-minute mark of the third. The Blues trying to take both games here in Toronto. Scene will shift to St. Louis for games Sunday and Tuesday. Toronto needing this one badly. Power play has kind of been wiped out for Toronto tonight. They are 0-for-7 on the power play.
Well, when you get 7 power plays in a Stanley Cup playoff game, you got to score more than 0 if you want a winner.
McInnes around the net for the Blues and coming up. Warner in there trying to check his man. It is Murphy picking it off the boards. Couldn't make the move quickly. Murphy going after it again. The Blues take over. McInnes backs up. Lifted a high one to center. Wrapped into the zone by Todd Gill. And McInnes back again. Boy, he's been on the ice a lot tonight. Al McInnes shooting it away. Toronto going back. Both teams forechecking well now. Offside. Zezel thought he had a break, but he's offside. And again, we visit with Ron McLean and just up there.
Warner threw a big hit on Al McInnes, but McInnes sees him coming and stiffens up. And Warner goes down. But McInnes stops skating, and the puck dribbled off his stick.
Puck shot in deep again. It is Gilmore poking at it all the way down the ice. Huddy turns back. Toronto waiting at the line, but not long enough. That's offside, called again. We mentioned the time Al McInnes has lost. Over 26 minutes now, Harry, in this hockey game.
And this is routine for him. And there you can see the nasty cut over the left eye of Snyder. He got that in the first period. They took him to the hospital, gave him the okay to come back, screwed a shield on his helmet, and here he is.
Just about hitting the halfway mark of the third period. And a lot riding on the next 10 minutes of this game.
For the Leafs especially, Bob, to go down 2-0 and head into enemy territory is not an inviting scene.
Bonner takes it from Kravchuk. Comes up to center and he blasts a long one in, wide of the net to the right of Potvin. 3 Leafs jump on it and come out quickly. Hart gets the pass. Tuella shoots. Nice love save by John Casey. That one was going in.
Accelerate. Score his 60th playoff goal to put the Leafs ahead, or put the Blues ahead. And here the Blues nearly make it a 2-goal edge. And here's the goal by Hull. Boy, there's no room. He's got to turn the puck over almost to get it in. Look where his feet are. Behind the icing line, and he shot it at an almost impossible angle.
Abella trying to get it up to Sundin. Couldn't quite manage that. Down and Ellis come back to pick it up in behind Felix Potvin. St. Louis leading by a goal. 7:35 remaining. It's Gilmore coming in with Sundin. Puck firing back to the net to Clark. He is tied up by Corson. Ellen in for Gilmore. Sundin has to come back to give him some help. Gets it out to McCown. Shoots! Another great glove save by John Casey. visit Rahmatlane.
Thank you, Bob. Let's go to Denver with the score 4-3, Vancouver.
Well, here's the stop by Casey, a difficult one, and it was labeled. Jamie McCown, who hasn't scored a goal all year, nearly got the biggest one of the season for him, and a huge one for the Leafs, but Casey denied it.
St. Louis leading in the series 1-0 on the 3-1 win on Tuesday here in Toronto. And leading in this game 4-3 with 7:20 remaining. The way the two teams have been playing now, the post-checking style, goals are tough to come by.
I think Paul Stewart, did he lose his whistle? Or did it break? And they're sending him in for the backup whistle. Yes. Stewart's got something to say about to the security people here about somebody throwing something on the ice, perhaps. And that draws the ire of many of the fans. They should throw everybody out that throws anything on the ice. Get a picture of them. Don't let them back in here for about a year.
7:20 remaining, third period. This crowd trying to generate an attack or two for the Maple Leafs. Murphy shot it in. Muller tried to tip it. He was flattened in front of the net by Barron. Tavish rolled a pass up there. Pearson going along the boards with Gill. Pearson gets it out for McTavish. Murphy grabs it, goes back to the net to Todd Gill. He's met immediately, so he moves it fast. But Pearson brings it back in with Portnoy getting ready. The shot blocked. And Ponta had to move away with Pearson again coming in. Like a freight train.
Gonna get a penalty, Bob. Pearson, who loves to go to the net, draws a penalty with 6:46 to go.
Not mistaken, I think I saw Stewart make the sign for a misconduct penalty. We'll see.
He's explaining to Al MacInnis what the penalty is, and there have been a host of penalties tonight, some of them quite mysterious. Well, have a look at Pearson, number 12 in blue, going to the net on the far side. And was he tripped? Or did he have something to say? Or
gone. He's heading to the far end of the gardens, and that's where the Blues dressing room is.
And there it is right there. You can see he's complaining to Stewart.
2 minutes for goaltender interference and a 10-minute misconduct.
There it is.
Time.
So he gets the two, and then he gets the 10. 6:46 to go. He has to hope for overtime if he wants to return.
A 10-minute misconduct. 13-14.
When the Blues look at the tape of that penalty, though, they're going to complain that Murphy tripped Pearson.
We are down to 6:46 left to play in the third period, and the St. Louis Blues are leading.
Larry Murphy lets the shot go that's tipped right there by Kirk Muller, and a nice stop at the right foot of John Casey, who Bob has really done a nice job filling in for the injured Grant Fuhr.
Yes, he has. Leafs have had 34 shots now. Blues 29. A chance for Toronto on the power play. Goal for 7 in the game. Casey steering it aside. And back out for Barron. Long shot in high over the net. Carter races for it. Picked it with a skate. Didn't know he had a chance on it. And went by Gagne, he did not see it. Schneider kept it in. Three Leafs get after it. They're on the power play. It is Gardner. Back to Schneider, and there's Murphy. To Schneider. Shoot! He missed. Again, Murphy giving it to Schneider a second time. Rolled it in the slot area. Murphy again. Sharp angle for him. He won't shoot from there. Up front. Score! Muller! Score! The 4-4.
Some assists are given when you just touch the puck. Some are given when you show all kinds of patience. And Larry Murphy makes a brilliant play here. First he faked McTavish to his feet and then threw it on the short side, as every one of the Blues thought he might be going behind the net. And Kirk Muller scores on a wrist shot low to the right side of John Casey.
Gilmore shoots. Casey stopped that easy shot from an angle by Gilmore, who was falling. 5:17 remaining.
Well, a turnover in the neutral zone. You know how many times we've talked about how dangerous they are, and that's what gave the Leafs this opportunity. It ended up not being a great shot. Kravchuk's got the puck here. All kinds of time. He tries to throw it through Doug Gilmore's legs. Can't get it through. The 3-on-2 ensues, and Gilmore got a shot while he was falling and didn't get much on it.
Kirk tries a shot. That hit Domi standing in front of the net. Gagne backhands it at the goal, but it's cleared out by the St. Louis Blues. The game tied at 4 goals now, with 5 minutes remaining in the third period. In game 2 of this best of 7 Western quarterfinal, the Blues and the Leafs. St. Louis stepping up there. They were down 2 goals twice in the game. Came back. Then take a lead. Now the Leafs have tied it. Creighton taken in on the boards by Leaf defenseman Allen. Then he was upended. Referee right there close, watching all the goings on.
Boy, I'd stay out of these. You don't know what Paul Stewart's going to call tonight.
Clark steps in. You heard the crowd. Domi is in close. You heard the crowd. And now Stewart is handing out some orders. Is that all? Or maybe more?
But is one team going to get the extra penalty? I mean, be careful, both teams. Stewart has been unpredictably predictable tonight.
We'll be back. The penalty box on sportsmanlike conduct penalties. 4 minutes and 34 seconds remaining in the third period.
Well, Noonan started the problem here by throwing an elbow right there on Todd Gill. Gill had the presence of mind not to retaliate, but on the same shift, about 10 seconds later, here's what happened. Noonan tried to dig the puck out from underneath Ellett, and Gagne and Noonan get 2 minutes apiece. And we're 4 skaters against 4. It was 4:34 to go, and the score is 4-4.
The Blues trying to take a 2-game lead in the series. Starting out, Rangers looking pass, but it got to McGinnis. Up to Gretzky, into Hall, shoots! Nice save, Putman, big rebound, and slapped away by Schneider all the way down the ice. But it's through the crease area. No icing. Blues start up again with McGinnis. Hall. Gretzky to his right. Hall lost it. And Dave Ellett for the Maple Leafs turns. He has Muller moving up. He has tied the game. Now the shot by Muller. And he might get another poking at it. The first one blocked by Barron. It goes into the corner at the far side. And Pronger was there first. Starts out, lost it to Presley. Played it on an open wing. And the Blues, Cortnell was back. Barron flying into the boards trying to clear it. Barron coming away. The pass to center to Cortnell. Cortnell trying to go in. He could not fool Schneider. Snider moving hard. Dumped it ahead, out over the line. And Pronger gets set to play it ahead again. Portman lost it. Gilmore coming in. And to back off. Now the setup for Gil. Gil left it. It's Sundin coming to the corner. In around the net. Gilmore right behind him to Sundin. He goes back to Gilmore again, and he missed it. Gil is pinching in. The Blues trying to get it out there with Gil in deep. And Kravchuk waited. Now he's away. Up to center, Kravchuk to the left to Cordinal. Cordinal coming for the net, trying to set it up. Sundin racing hard with McGinnis. Al McGinnis seems to be out there all night long. He's up to center. Dumping it in. There's Corson on it. Gil for Toronto left it behind the net. The penalized players are back on. Five aside now. And here's Gartner speeding in with Warriner shooting. That was blocked in front of the net. Back the other way for Noonan. He had to go to center and then shoot it in. And the Blues are changing. 2 minutes and 15 seconds remaining in regulation time. We're in a 4-4 tie. Here's McCown. Put himself offside, but the Blues are going to clear it. The Leafs get back onside anyway. So the play will continue. Knocked down by Schneider. Matos stopped him from moving anywhere. Crowd trying to get the Leafs one more goal and tie the series. Warriner lost it to Leach. Schneider backing up now to Warriner. He shoots it in. He wants to get to the lead bench. 1:35 remaining in regulation time. In a 4-4 tie here in game two. Presley shot nowhere near the net. It'll come out to center. Flip back in. Muller. Oh, it hit somebody at the Blues bench. Muller took a hit. Kravchuk. The whistle stopped the play. We have 1 minute and 23 seconds remaining in the third period here in game two at Toronto. It is Toronto 4, St. Louis 4.
It hit Murray Barron's leg that was hanging over the bench, and that caused the whistle. And here's the hit on Muller that he didn't appreciate after the whistle. So with 1:23 to go, the physical animosity has not decreased very much at all. Kirk Muller has been strongly tonight. We are 1:23 away from a possible fourth period.
Well, we're just about overtime now. For all intents and purposes, down to 1:23 left. Face off at the St. Louis blue line. The Blues control it. McGinnis again. Lifting one from his own side of center, however. And Schneider touches it. That's an icing call against the Blues. 1:13 remaining.
Boy, if I was both coaches, I'd have two centers out there, two guys that can take the draws, because the referee and linesmen have thrown 25 of them out tonight, especially St. Louis. You don't want a winger taking the faceoff here. And so McTavish, who's taken a lot of big faceoffs, is out there. So is Corson and Gretzky. So Mike Keenan covers his tracks well here. Greg McTavish, unspectacular offensively, although he does have 2 points tonight. Reliable completely defensively.
Faceoff to the right of Casey, deep in the blue zone. McGinnis again. Leaving it for Gretzky. Through the middle, trying to hit Corson with the pass. The goal right at Potvin. 1 minute
left. Last minute of play in this period.
4-4 tie. Here's Clark. Got up over the line. Sundin was with him. He missed Ellett with the pass. Ellett stopped the clearing attempt. Gilmore knocked it down. Gilmore stopped by Gretzky, and look out, Gretzky is away. He's coming up over the Leaf line, faking everybody. Oh, that low shot nearly caught the corner. He centers it out of hole. He fired a hot one. That's blocked. Blues coming close. 30 seconds left in regulation. And Gretzky now turning it on. Back to the line. Huddy to Gretzky. To Huddy. shot. Blocked in front. And the play is stopped. I'll say hearts are almost stopped with Gretzky and Hall coming very close to winning the game with only 12 seconds remaining. 4-4 tie.
Gilmore blocks the shot from the grassy knoll there, gets the whistle with 12.2 seconds left. And Wayne Gretzky nearly got the corner, Bob, on a rush to end this baby. Clark is knocked down, and Gretzky just grazes the left post. And we're 12 seconds away from overtime. The faceoff is in the Leafs zone, but not on the dot. And here's Gilmore, boy. He took this baby right in the sea. For captain. Courageous.
Face off deep in the lead zone. They win it. McKinnis shot it. Blocker saved by Pontvan. 7 seconds remaining. Schneider lost it into the skates of the referee. It comes out in front. And the horn goes to end the third period.
Here's another break. Barrionov with Ozolin. Barrionov makes the shot. In on goal. Couldn't get the shot away.
Gary Suter, but the Canucks keeping the Hawks outside right now. Nichols centered, Murphy scores!
Koski couldn't reach it. Here he comes, a shot score! Philadelphia on the puck quickly. Redbird racing over center. He's coming in. A pass back. Holler scores. Holler wins it for Philadelphia.
Steve Smith ahead to Murphy. Nichols at the line. Chelios moving in. Chelios scores. Chris Chelios has won it for Chicago.
Here's a 4-on-2 to Jersey. They set up now. Rusted has some trouble. They score! Steel drives in overtime. And the Devils win 2-1.
At the other end, Eddie Savard was loose. But they kept the puck along the boards. Now comes free. Here's Savard. Denny Chelios scores! Chris Chelios has done it again! And the Hawks move on to the conference final. Primo on the faceoff wins it back to Lindstrom. The shot scores! And Daze has it. The Hawks break out. Daze handed it to Fedosov. Looked like a promising break for Chicago. But now Konstantinov moves up. His shot scores! Konstantinov! And Belfour whiffed on it, and Detroit wins it.
Out with Redbird. Up across center, the Philadelphia Flyers bring it in. Here's Lindros. Scores! Eric Lindros scoring for Philadelphia. And they defeat the Devils 3-2.
Here's Kozlov dancing in. Takes the shot. Scores!
Overtime Magic, brought to you by B.F. Goodrich. Show them your true colors.
The phone lines are open. Here's the number to call and tell us who will score tonight's winning goal in the B.F. Goodrich TA Overtime Magic Contest. Tonight's contest will close with the winning goal, so show us your true colors. Call now, 1-900-870-2556.
In a way,
here in game two, Hull right off the bat. Is checked and can't get a shot on the net. Schneider, he's away to center. Flip the puck in back to the net. Peachy is out. Corson tapped it to center. Got it back from Gretzky, and he's up there with Barron right behind him. Montan, the save on the short side. Hull intercepted the clearing play. Now McKinnis! What a save by Potvin! On a bullet! McKinnis got all of it. And Potvin got a little more. Back in for Ellett. Offside! On the far side was Matt Sundin. Wow.
Nobody shoots it any harder from the point than Al McKinnis, who played 33 minutes and 45 seconds of regulation time, and he tested Felix Potvin with one of his special shots, and Potvin beat him. Not from the blue line, from 32 feet out off the shoulder of Potvin. A big time stop here in overtime.
McKinnis coming in and walking right into that shot. Hot pass, stopped it. So the Leafs get a life. Gill trying to pinch his man on the boards. Murphy finally stopped it. The puck was into the crowd.
Toronto Maple Leafs 4-2-12 in overtime this year. The St. Louis Blues 1-1-16. A few players playing in this game who have scored big time overtime goals. Do you think Mike Keenan wishes Glenn Anderson, one of the overtime specialists in the National Hockey League, was on the bench tonight? He's not dressed.
Castle now comes on for St. Louis to take this face off deep in the lead zone to the right of Potvin. A little delay. Sundin skated out of the circle, as did Zezel. Now they're ready. Here comes Zezel. Murphy going after it. Takes it. Pounds it on the boards and gets it out. Hunter was waiting for it. Huddy shooting it back in. Murphy nearly lost it at the side of the net. Got away with that one. Toronto's Gartner. Up it goes to Gagne, to Sundin. Tipped away by Huddy. Gill near center ice. He lost it against Zezel, who comes along the boards with Cardinal. Cardinal gets away and then fell. Cardinal got back up. Controlled it with a skate. Larry Murphy for the Maple Leafs. Convery with him, but he goes to Gartner, who skates away with a long shot. Rising off the glass and down for Casey to smother it.
Glenn Anderson, who has not dressed for either game, is hanging out in the Leaf alumni box. He is a Leaf alumnus. We know that. And he's leaving now in a hurry, perhaps. Mike Keenan won't let any of his non-dressed players be interviewed. He won't let anybody talk about the injuries.
Everybody is tense now. We are in overtime here in game two. These two will go to St. Louis. Either the Blues will be up 2-0. Home ice advantage, or the Leafs will tie the series. Creighton coming over center. Striding in for a shot. Hoffman hugging the post. It's centered. Hoffman had to be careful with that, with Mateau parked right in front of him. Leafs get it up. Muller, he tied the game for Toronto. Now Craig shoots. Waited maybe a little too long. It was telegraphed all right, and then deflected into the crowd.
Oh, nice drop pass by Muller, hoping Craig, and then Muller went to the net, hoping Craig could get the shot through, and even if he didn't score, perhaps Muller could grab the rebound. But the puck was neatly deflected up, well up into the end blues here. Here's the shot right here. You can see where Muller's going. He wants to get in there and see if he can grab a rebound. McKinnis did a nice job riding him behind the net.
And Mateau getting a stick down in front of the shot from Craig. He played 2:09 of overtime. face off just inside the Blues line. Orson and Muller hooking up. Finally dropped in and shot away down the ice to Potvin. Red Hall is forechecking. Quick pass on the boards to Warner. He tried to fool Corson. He had a chance to clear it again. Kept in deep for Corson. Look out. He centered it. Here comes Gretzky and went off his stick and got out the center. Blues get back on side. Schneider. Blues getting a couple of good chances there. Nearly another one. Presley gave it away. Schneider turns. McCown with a pass. And he slides it up. Muller takes it in with Presley. Trying to poke at it. Doesn't. Two Blues get going, but that's a glove pass. And it'll be called back. And Ron is still busy down there. Here's another update.
Craig Berube.
We are nearing the 3-minute mark of overtime. 28 total penalties. We have another one called now. 26 minors make it 27 at this stage. Two misconducts. 8 power plays each, and now the Blues caught with too many men on the ice.
Well, the Leafs have a power play in overtime. You don't see a lot of those.
Penalty will be served by number 14, Jeff Corton.
And can the Leafs take advantage of this situation and get the winner? I can't remember seeing a too many men penalty in overtime, can you?
That's a tough one, but it's happened here in this overtime. The Leafs 1-for-8, the power play in the game.
However, the one did tie the game up, so see what happens here.
Well, it's an opportunity for the Maple Leafs. Also remembering Barron scored in a shorthanded goal in the second period for St. Louis. Now Toronto on the power play. Here in game two, trying to knock the series. They go in. Gilmore racing for it. Had to poke at it. The Leafs have it inside the line to Gilmore. Sundin is with it. When it comes to Sundin, back it goes. Side of the net. Gilmore Sundin. Oh, he had to end it, but he missed it. Blues clear it out. The house buzzing on that chance by Sundin. The Leafs come at him again. Murphy over the line. Dumping it off to the corner. Gilmore played the man Barron. Now he's after the puck. And he does get it loose. Sundin. Right at back of the net. Gilmore up to the left front. Sundin again to the line. Murphy to Sundin. With the pass to the far side. Schneider rolled it in to Gilmore back of the net. Gilmore with Sundin out front. Here's a shot. And Sundin and the Leafs tie the series.
Between his right arm and his body, then roll halfway to the back of the net.
4:02, the time of the winning goal. Sundin from Gilmore and Schneider. Leafs win it.
2.1 The Edge is Toronto's new rock.
Always has been.
Always will be.
Red Hot Chili Peppers.
Stone Temple Pilots.
R.E.M.
Pearl Jam. Collective Soul.
Nirvana.
Nine Inch Nails.
Oasis.
The Smashing Pumpkins.
The world is a vampire.
Everything else is history.
Toronto's new rock, 102.1, The Edge. Discover it.
Reinhold Bertleff had a key role in the building of Porsche's 911 Carrera. Did he design the engine? The radical suspension? No. Instead, Reinhold and his co-workers have perhaps the best job in the world. They test drive every 911 on the Autobahn. If Reinhold liked your car, we're pretty sure you like your car.
Molson Hockey Night in Canada on CBC. Brought to you by Molson Canadian.
Toronto Maple Leafs level the series. The Molson three stars, Craig McTavish, Kirk Muller, and Matt Sundin, who for the second time this year beats the Blues in overtime, and he's with Scott Oakes. Scott.
All right, Ron. Matt Sundin gets the winner, 4:02 into the extra period. Matt, so I'll leave it to you to tell me how badly you needed this one.
Well, especially losing the first game and being down 4-3 in the end of the third period, huge win for us. Going back on the road now and going in.